there is a new lung cancer screening called Electromagnetic Navigation Bronchoscopy, or ENB. As Dr. Ziad Tannous of Desert Comprehensive Cancer Center tells us, with this technology, doctors can reach areas in the lungs that were not accessible through conventional bronchoscopy.
What bronchoscopy is basically a little camera with a channel cord that goes down and visualizes the airway from the inside. The bronchoscope, which is the old bronchoscopy, would go down, you go through the main airway, the trachea, or the windpipe, and then it branches out, and then you're able to go maybe beyond the third, maybe the fourth, fifth generation if you're lucky with the smaller scopes, and that's as far as you could go. The new bronchoscopy technology, which is the EMB, electromagnetic navigational bronchoscopy, is where we first do the CT scan of the chest. Second, we plan the procedure ahead of time, so we know where the lesion, where we are, and how we're gonna get to the lesion. And three, the actual procedure. So when the actual procedure takes place is where we're bringing in the patient, put them under sedation, sedate the patient, make them comfortable. Sometimes you need general anesthesia. And we put them on an electromagnetic field. It's a special board that is in the back and put in, and leads put in on the top of the chest. And that way the lung is mapped out in a three-dimensional fashion. And then we incorporate the CT scan, the roadmap we planned ahead of time, and the actual bronchoscopy. Now we're able to find smaller and smaller lesions early in the course of the disease. In the past, we used to look at the small lesion and we have limited options. An option of waiting and doing what we call serial CT scan every few months and monitor that lesion. The second option used to be doing a what we call a transthoracic needle aspirate, where we go from the outside of the chest wall. The third thing is invasive surgical procedure, where patients actually go to surgery and take that out. So those are our options up until this point, where we have this new technology now, and we are able to track down those smaller, more kind of peripheral lesions, okay, with this new technology, and try to sample those lesions with accuracy, avoiding the invasive procedures, avoiding the higher complication rates of the transthoracic needle aspirates that we used to deal with in the past. Once we are able to sample, have a diagnosis, then we come back to the patient and discuss it again as a team and see what's the best approach, because we still have to, after making the initial diagnosis, we have to stage the cancer, if it is cancer. And then we need to assess the patient's physiology and see if they're able to go to certain treatments over the other and which one is the best approach. Sometimes surgery is the best approach. Sometimes it's a combination of surgery and chemotherapy. And sometimes it's radiation therapy or any combination of those three. Now we are able to diagnose lung cancer in a much earlier stage. And by doing so, we're able to save lives and improve their mortality and the quality of life. And this is done non-invasively. Essentially, there is no cuts, and patients go home the same day when we do this type of procedure.
Lung cancer screenings are meant to find the disease before any symptoms are present. So make sure you get the proper screenings early to minimize complications later. For the American Health Journal, I'm Laura Windsor.